Only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with you? Like a river flows surely to the sea.
Come away with me in the night. Come away with me and I will write you a song. Come away with me. Come away where they can't tempt us with their lies. And I want to walk with you on a cloudy day in fields where the yellow grass grows knee high. So won't you try? Come away with me and we'll kiss on a mountain top. Come away with me and I'll never stop loving you.
Suddenly everything changed. They're spreading blankets on the beach. Yours is the first face that I saw. I think I was blind before I met you. And I don't know where I am, I don't know where I've been, but I know where I want to go. So I thought I'd let you know. Yeah, these things take forever, I especially am slow. But I realized that I need you, and I wondered if I could come home. Mm-hmm. time you drove all night just to meet me in the morning. And I thought it was strange, you said everything changed. You felt as if you just woke up, and you said, "This is the first day of my life. I'm glad I didn't die before I met you. But now I don't care, I could go anywhere with you, and I'd probably be happy. So if you wanna be with me, if these things there's no telling, we just have me."
Who gives this bride to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Please be seated. Let us pray. God, we ask your blessings upon this couple as we celebrate this momentous occasion in their lives. Grant them happiness and contentment as they establish their new home, create a new family, and explore the depths of their love for one another and for you. Bless their families and friends and the relationships which have supported and strengthened them throughout their lives. Bless their home as a place of love and peace, and if times grow hard and tempers grow short, help them to look into their hearts and remember the love that brought them here today. Amen. Friends and family, we have gathered to give recognition to the worth and beauty of love and to add our best wishes to the words which shall unite Sera and Chris in marriage. Sera and Chris are grateful to each of you for making the journey to be here today. Learning to love and living together is one of the greatest joys of life, and is the shared goal of married life. We learn to love by being loved. Love is given to us by our families and friends. That is why your presence here is so important. You have created a circle of love throughout Sera and Chris's lives, like the circle of the rings they will exchange today. And they ask that you continue to love and support them as they grow together. Although we go forth from the homes of our childhood, we never outgrow the special love and support of our parents. We also pause to remember those friends and family members who have passed on. Their spirits join our circle today. In this celebration of love, Sera and Chris honor and support all the loving relationships of their friends and family. They ask that all of us gathered here today take a moment to reflect upon our relationships with family and friends and delight in how blessed we have been. April, Sera's mom, will now honor us with a selected reading, The Essence of Marriage.
Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It is never going to sleep angry. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is a standing together facing the world. It is a forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is giving things to each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not expecting the husband to wear a halo or the wife to have wings of an angel. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is finding room for the things of the spirit. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget, and then forgetting what you forgave. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and the obligations are reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right person, but being the right partner.
Marriage is more than the legal joining of two individuals. It is the outward recognition of a deep and growing friendship. It is a constant accepting of each other's weaknesses and strengths. It is a daily commitment of growing in love forever. There will be times in which each of you will behave in less than a loving way. These are the times your love will be tested. These are the times when your commitment to love must enable you to see the divine within the other. Always look for the higher spirit of love in each other when your love and marriage are being tested by your humanness. As Robert Louis Stevenson said, marriage is one long conversation, checkered by disputes, but in intervals, almost unconsciously, and with no desire to shine, the whole material of life is turned over and over. Ideas are struck out and shared. The two persons more and more adapt their notions, one to suit the other. And in process of time, without sound of trumpet, they conduct each other into new worlds of thought. Chris and Sarah, having found one another, you now stand here together before your friends and family. As husband and wife, each of you will look to the other for gentleness, for support, for understanding, and for love. Be continually sensitive to each other's needs. Your life and love will be each other's greatest source of joy. I ask now, do you come without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage and to live your lives together?
We do.
Will you encourage each other and stand by each other in your life together? And will you grow with each other in the shelter of your love?
We will.
All of you who witness these vows, will you do everything in your power to support and uphold Chris and Sarah in their marriage? If so, please respond, we will.
We will.
Please hold hands. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch, will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will help you to hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Remember this moment in time as you say your vows to each other. Chris, please repeat after me. I choose you to be my partner.
I choose you to be my partner.
And now I join my life with yours.
And now I join my life with yours.
I vow to love, trust, and accept you.
I vow to love, trust, and accept you.
Encourage and embrace you.
Encourage and embrace you.
All that I am and all that I shall be.
All that I am and all that I shall be.
I entrust to your heart, my beloved.
I entrust to your heart, my beloved.
On this sacred day.
On this sacred day.
And tomorrow.
And tomorrow.
And always.
And always.
And Sarah, please repeat after me. I choose you to be my partner.
I choose you to be my partner.
And now I join my life with yours.
And now I join my life with yours.
I vow to love, trust, and accept you.
I vow to love, trust, and accept you.
Encourage and embrace you.
Encourage and embrace you.
All that I am and all that I shall be.
All that I am and all that I shall be.
I entrust to your heart, my beloved.
I entrust in your heart, my beloved.
On this sacred day.
On this sacred day.
And tomorrow.
And tomorrow.
And always.
And always.
May the words spoken here remain in the hearts of this couple. Now, before Sarah and Chris exchange the wedding rings, they ask if each of you would pass the rings from one person to the other. When it is your turn to hold them in your hand, would you take a moment and bless the rings with your love and then pass them to the person sitting next to you? Let us begin.
Thank you.
May you always remember how your rings were warmed by the love of your family and friends. Rings are an ancient symbol, blessed and simple, round like the sun, like the eye, like arms that embrace, circles like love that is given, come back round again and again. Therefore, may these symbols remind you that your love, like the sun, illuminates, that your love, like the eye, must see clearly, and that your love, like arms that embrace, is a grace upon this world. Chris, if you would place the ring on Sarah's finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love for you.
As a symbol of my love for you.
Let it be a reminder.
Let it be a reminder.
That I am always close at hand.
That I am always close at hand.
And that I will always be faithful to you.
And that I will always be faithful to you.
And Sarah, if you would take the ring for Chris, and as you place it on his finger, repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love for you.
As a symbol of my love for you.
Let it be a reminder.
Let it be a reminder.
That I am always close at hand.
That I am always close at hand.
And that I will always be faithful to you.
And that I will always be faithful to you.
Now, may we have a moment of silence, so that each of you in your own way offer a silent blessing, that the spirit of this gathering blesses the union of Sarah and Chris. May God be with you and bless you. May you see your children's children. May you be poor in misfortune, rich in blessings. May you know nothing but happiness from this day forward. Because Sarah and Chris have proclaimed their love and their wish to unite as one by the saying of vows and the exchange of rings, so also do I declare that Chris and Sarah are now husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Family and friends, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Chris and Sarah Goldie.
There's no combination of words I can put on the back of a postcard. No song that I can sing, but I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions of my heart. Like, why are we here and where do we go and how come we're so hard? It's not always easy and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars when we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. I find their way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do, but if all of these dreams might find their way into
Chris
my day to day,
ask, what that you enjoy light refreshment while photographs are being made. Thank you.
Not so many things we got to do, or places we got to be. We'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. We're some.